It's time. So welcome everybody to this first session of the Happy Day event this year. We are very happy with Arnaud to participate once again. So I'm Michel Ara, I'm a hybrid cloud architect working with Arnaud on integration subject like API, bus, messaging, etc.
Good. I'm Arnaud Desprez. I'm working on the integration space for a few years now, and I'm specializing in API management and secure gateway in general, and also ESB and even now. So we start with the overall picture. This is a well-known picture within IBM and very well documented. There's a links at the bottom of this slide. So what we see, we're not going to look at it every single piece, but what we see here, several aspects. We can see on the right that now when we do architecture and integrate systems, there are various types of interaction, and we see synchronous, asynchronous, in even bash interaction. So in synchronous, we have the famous REST and SOAP over HTTP. For asynchronous, we have messaging and events. We will come back to exactly what we mean here. What we see also on this slide is the fact that architecture now are more and more hybrid. And that's why we see on-premise and multi-cloud provider on the top right of this picture. Another part we can see is fact that API and event are converging in the sense that we are starting to manage API and event in the same way, and there is a need for to govern those API and events in a similar way. Also, another aspect of this diagram is the fact that we have more and more distributed architecture with microservice-driven architecture, and the integration layer can be in a lot of forms, like a traditional integration, like big ESB, but also a need for small parts where we have to integrate and provide messaging, aggregation, etc., at the application level. So a lot of things on this slide. And of course, today we are going to talk more about the API and event management. So what are the governance challenges regarding those API? We talk about event-driven architecture and message-oriented architecture. That's the new guys on this picture. And also, of course, the old SOA and API, REST API management. So the action we are concerned is how do I know an API exists? So having a catalog of finding where the API are, who owns it, and there is this notion of API discovery. So discover API which exists in the various application. It's interesting to notice that not all APIs are managed. We may have application with some APIs like the one on my mouse, which does not expose an API and we don't want to manage, and some we want to manage them and expose them. What other challenge we have in managing those API is the lifecycle, and important is the versioning of those API. And we can see that with event-driven, with the loose coupling characteristic of this EDA, it's also an important challenge, and that's why we need to cover those event API. Understanding who consumes them and how are they consumed. We discussed very briefly about manage versus unmanage. It's important to also consider that not all API should be managed. There is a cost to do that. And sometimes if we have an API which is a point-to-point in a very specific application, maybe we don't want to manage it and govern it completely, and that would be too expensive to do that, and no need for doing that. Because EDA and message-oriented architecture provide loose coupling, and because it's a distributed architecture, that increase those governance challenges and we had with a traditional API, hence why we really need to support and govern those API. A few interactions, so it's more in styles of interaction with API, and what we see here is towards asynchronous type of interaction, and we have a few patterns here where we have like a common pattern, and we have an API here. And so the application sends a request and there is only an acknowledgement. So it's kind of a one-way service, but there is no response with a big body. But we can still do those interaction with an API. Here it's a hybrid approach. So we keep, we have a request response with a synchronous API, but it will drive and emit an event. That will go to a topic, and then the app can subscribe to this topic and be informed of the new events that comes to this topic. And we also have the last way of interaction, where the topic directly emits apps for the apps which have subscribed to the topic, so it's completely asynchronous. So those, all those kind of interaction should be covered, and you can see that we can use asynchronous approach or synchronous approach. Just a small digression of we have put this slide just to remind that we really differentiate message-oriented architecture and event-driven architecture in the sense that we don't use both for the same thing. They are very different. So this is not the purpose of this presentation, but just to remind that message queuing is very interesting for point-to-point, and where delivery is very important, and we cannot lose any message, and we are more in a request reply mode. I'm not saying that we cannot do a pub sub with message queuing, but the main scenario are about transient data. As soon as the message is sent and consumed, the message disappears. Event streaming is completely different. It's not one or the other. They are completing each other. In event streaming, we have this notion of history, and we have immutable data, and the data will stay in the topic till it does timeout, or indefinitely if we don't want a timeout for a very long time. It's really towards a scalable consumption, where we have lots of consumers. Of course, again, we can do pub sub with MQ, but Kafka is really the goal was for this scalable consumption, and the fact, as we said, about this immutable data, which can raise some nice challenge when we consider GDPR as well. Again, how do we remove data that should be removed for compliance, for example? So both are very, very complementary technologies. So what we see right now is what we have is a multi-form APIs, and they come. What we just say is that they come in many shapes, and I think it's very interesting to go back in the past, in the 2000s years, when SOA came to the table. We had a very strong emphasis on multi-protocol, and we had this notion of binding and the abstraction of the protocol. And when REST came, it was trying to get away from the complexity of SOA, I think. And I think it's pretty funny to see that we are coming back to some of those principles, slightly differently, of course, but trying to have API on those multi-protocols. So in this picture, we see several style of API and protocol supported. So of course, we have the SOAP API and REST API with the Open API specification and Swagger. We have the GraphQL, which is very interesting for flexible and allow to minimize the version of API, more style of consuming APIs than protocol driven. And now we have asynchronous API, basically, especially for IBM, API that are implemented with Kafka. So we have this specification, which has been around for more than 3 or 4 years. I think we discussed that in the API Days conference about 4 years ago. It started to see some light on the asynchronous API. Now we have implementation, and we have the Michel will do a demonstration of what we do with asynchronous API in a few minutes. But we support Kafka. Interesting. So for gRPC and webhooks, I must admit I don't know specification, but they are coming in the plan. There are some specification to cover that. And for MQ, IBM is already submitting proposal for covering MQ-based API in the asynchronous API specification. So there are proposals for now, but there is all a work, all piece of work to address MQ also API. But today we will discuss API with Kafka protocol. I like this diagram. It's just to show you. You see on the left here, we see an asynchronous definition. So it's not anymore Swagger 2.0 or OpenAPI 3. It's async API. So you see it's really it's not the same specification document. But when we look at the specification of both REST traditional OpenAPI and asynchronous API, we see a lot of similarities. So the color coding here is like the blue, dark blue. It's very, very similar on both specification. And the light blue here, just to say, well, we have the same thing, except it's adapted to the specificities of async API, Kafka APIs, or synchronous with request response, and with message, with headers and payload, traditional information we need for a message here and traditional information we need for a synchronous API. So very similar, just the names are different, and we have the similarities. We also have the exact same definition. And then for the components, same thing, we have, and in purple, we have specificities for asynchronous API, like correlation IDs. That's something we encounter very frequently with asynchronous message. So they are specific to the async API, but it's just normal. And we have similarities on the component, like the definition. So the schema definition in OpenAPI, JSON schema or XML schema, or schema for the async API. So you see all this very similar. It's not very complex, but there are a few components in those specs. So just a few more terminology we use in asynchronous API. Of course, the world would be simple if we were using all the same word everywhere, but just a small focus here on the fact that Kafka calls a broker. We have the notion of broker in the async API. It's called a message broker. We have a producer versus publisher. So you see that it's a little bit... not exactly the same terminology used, but it's pretty understandable for all those words used either in the Kafka world, either in asynchronous API specification. I've put this link here. It's a colleague of us who have created a blog, Dale Lane, explaining exactly with sample each part of the asynchronous API, and I think it's very very good document and a very good source, and shows both sample and explanation for every single part of the API spec. So every single part that we see in this document is explained, and with sample and good explanation. So what IBM has done in the synchronous space is basically we have two offerings. One is the traditional API Connect. This is an API management solution, which was made for a long time to support synchronous API. And we have added the asynchronous support. And we also have another offering, which is called Event Endpoint Manager, which is really to manage asynchronous API. And you don't need really to support synchronous API if you want, and if you don't need to. Having said that, we have the Event Endpoint Manager and API Connect do exist in an overall solution, which is called Cloud Pak for Integration. So just to remind what we mean by API Connect and API Management, we have the various traditional components, which are the manager, gateway, portal, and analytics. Portal is a Drupal implementation, and we are managing the full life cycle of the API, so the full life cycle management, which includes exposure, consumption, versioning, monetization, etc. And we can support asynchronous API in CP4I for and configure for events within API Connect. So API Connect can do both. Okay, so that's the complementarity of API Connect and supporting both both type of API. Event Endpoint Manager. So it's a new capability. We find the same approach, same governance support, except the gateway is slightly different. We have the event gateway that will be used to proxy Kafka, and I will show you in a few seconds the architecture of that. So, but this is an offering to do asynchronous API, and you will see that through the use of API Connect in Michel's demo. So again, this event endpoint management is to do the full life cycle. So we have the exposure, we have the schema definition, but we support the asynchronous specification for describing API, event API. With Event Manager, like API Connect, we can add the support of REST API in CP4 in the Cloud Pak, and we can support synchronous API. So you see, you can either use API Connect and add event API support, event-driven API support, or the other way. At the end of the day, this is the same operator to install and configure and manage both offerings. Just a reminder, so the Cloud Pak for Integration is a set of components, and that's the traditional component we had in this Cloud Pak. So the API management, the security gateway, which is also used by API Connect, we have the advanced ESB. We include Event Stream, so that's the fact that we can do a demonstration is pretty simple, because we can just have API Connect and configure it for event management. And we use the Event Stream, which is our Kafka added our Kafka supported product offering, and the fact that it is a IBM implementation, we have additional feature like the support of MQ connector, more simple HA topology and management, and specific UI to manage our event stream solution based on Kafka. It also includes MQ and Aspera for fast and secure transfer. So just to remind the challenge. It's another way of presenting a few things we discussed so far. So with event endpoint management, governing the event API, we need to describe the event. So that's why we need the interface, and we need to have versioning. And why we need to do that, and it's to be understood by people, supported by tooling, of course. That's why we follow the asynchronous API specification. And the good news is that we have a consistent approach and consistent way to manage and present those API within one tool. And as I said before, this is where we start to contribute to the asynchronous API specification regarding MQ. Okay, so we have done a few proposals. If you're interested to see how message-oriented architecture and API goes together and followed by the asynchronous API specification, you can go on this link. Another challenge, governance challenge, so the fact that is the fact that we can discover. So this is an area which again is investing, how to discover many APIs and not just explicitly define and import the specification, but discover the API in a service mesh or in a deployment or in a Kubernetes cluster. So what we want to do is to discover events and put them in the catalog. And you may recognize the same catalog as we use in API Connect to add the asynchronous API. So of course, that's what we say from the beginning. We have one place where we find the synchronous and asynchronous API in the same place, in the same way, and the same user interface. And of course, we can search them in this catalog. It doesn't mean that all API with discovery, an interesting aspect of discovery is that not all API must be enforced. We can just reference them, even if we don't want to enforce them. So that's interesting also to consider those API. So with this event API, like synchronous API, we provide self-service access. We can provide some policy enforcement. We can monitor the usage of those asynchronous API and provide a view to the consumers of how all those API loosely defined in this distributed architecture, this is what EDA are, and how they are consumed, and put some policies around them. So again, EDA is really present in the loosely coupled system. But of course, it needs some governance because of this loosely defined architecture. Okay, so we will govern data transformation, protocol translation also, and a very important versioning of those API. You know, the fact that everybody can publish API or message on a Kafka backbone, if everybody does that or everybody change a version all the time, it will not work. And that's one of the challenge of a big Kafka backbone is to govern them, and that's what I think API can do. That's my final slide. So here it's really the way it is implemented in the event manager. Similar to API Connect, we find the portal, the Drupal portal, and the manager to manage Kafka asynchronous API, and it will be it will interact with the event gateway, which is a proxy to the Kafka broker, and the API manager and the portal can get information or enforce policies on those API. But if we replace this gateway by the standard gateway with a standard synchronous backend, this is the same architecture we have in API Connect. There is also a demo here. And with that said, I think we have covered what I wanted to say. Just one slide to remind, and you will see that in the demo. So in event endpoint management, now it's a high-level capability in the sense that it is part of an offering. It is available already in 2023.1, the Cloud Pak for Integration version. We are going to produce and advertise even a base interface with a synchronous API spec, and that's what you see here, and that you can create it from Kafka topic, and that's the event gateway that you deploy in your Kafka cluster. So I'm done now for now. So I'm going to let Michel talk and close my phone.
Okay, thanks, Arno. Can you go to the next slide? Can you go to the next slide, please?
Yeah.
The demo. Yeah, sorry, just the visual slide. So,
do you want to take the? You can take the.
Yes, well, I can take it. Okay, I can. Yeah. So I have to launch. Sorry, the presentation.
Yeah, the share.
I will take the. Take the hand to install the demo. Sorry. Okay. Okay, sorry. So do you see my slide, Arno?
Yes.
Sorry. Okay. So just a demonstration, this demonstration around the scenario. Very simple. The scenario is about transportation. So this is the case when a flight is landing. If the number of passengers is higher than 50, we are going to find the taxi around the airport and then send them a message to announce that the flight is coming. So so in this demo, we are going to mix synchronous API and asynchronous API, I will show you. So we are managing the flight landing events. So when the flight landing, we will send an information with the number of passengers, the number of flight, etc. Then if the number is higher than 15, we will find the taxi nearby the airport using a GPS location, and then we will send message, API message to taxi to announce the flight. So very simple simple demo. Now this is the scenario: the flight land, more than 50 passengers, find a taxi, and then send them a message asking them to come to the airport to take the passengers. So very very easy. So now. Go to the demo. It's okay, Arno, you see my screen? I hope so. Yes, so in this yes. Demo, this is the API portal. And in this API portal, you can see the documentation of API, mixed synchronous and asynchronous API. Here we have two kind of API. One regarding the flight himself. So you can make a registration to this portal. Of course, you want to subscribe, you have to subscribe to a product and to an API to use it, like standard portal. So this is Drupal, an open source technology. So with the flight, I have two API. First is a landing API. So this is an async API. With Kafka, the protocol, not HTTP. It's possible to download the API documentation. So we will see now the operation. And this is an instruction with a Java code to consume the information in Kafka. So you can see the Bootstrap server. You can see an example to consume this message, very easy to do. So this is the same code in Java, because we will see the Java code. And very important, you can see the schema. So this is the schema, the Avro schema, very important to document where the way the content of the schema, the format, and this is very important to support Kafka schema registry and to document it, as said Arnaud previously, in a portal. So it's very, this is very important. So as I said, you have to subscribe, of course, to this API. And then we have, after the landing, you have also the takeoff information. So this is also an async API to be informed that the flight is be a takeoff. You can also download the API documentation. We will see an example just now. So as Arnaud mentioned, you know, this is async API and not Swagger like synchronous API. We can mention async API, you can mention the Bootstrap server, etc. And also we have some code example to use it in a Java program. We will see after that the full Java program to manage that. But first, you have all the documentation about how to use this API, and also this is the schema registry, which is very well documented. So the very interesting thing is, of course, to manage release, because your API will make some evolution with different release. You can manage all the release, all the lifecycle of the API. Also, we can see the schema now is not the async API, but the schema is documented. You can download it in a JSON format, so it's very easy to have the schema, of course, to import it and to use it. You know, the important thing is you see all is documented in a portal, so it's very easy to share in your organization or outside your organization with this portal. This is an open source technology with Drupal. Now we will look to the taxi part. There is a taxi messaging. This is synchronous API, traditional REST API with HTTP protocol. So we are more comfortable, of course, in this type of API. This is a post to send messages to all the taxi, of course. A simple post or very easy API. Also, with an example, we have example of this is the body, of course, of the message. So I'm sorry that the interface is in French because I'm French, but you can put it in English, of course, in every languages. You can test your API, of course, generate the body, and just send the traditional API on the portal. So it's very easy to do. So as you can see, in the same portal, Drupal portal, you have both synchronous and asynchronous API, as mentioned Arnaud just before. So you have all the details of the API, the answer, the body, of course. This is more traditional way to do. And now we will take a look. You can also download, of course, the Swagger. So now we have a traditional open API release is release free, open API with the all the information you need about security, about the endpoint, about the schema of the body, about the security aspect, API key, etc. Well, we are very traditional, open API way. And the last one you have to look is about taxi locator. So we saw previously a post. Now with this get, the goal of this API is to find the taxi location given a GPS coordinate. So very, very, very easy to do. So you put the GPS coordinate, and then in the response, we have all the taxi near the coordinate you mentioned. One again, you can of course download the Open API documentation, of course, to use it with the schema, one again, the content of the body, the security, etc., is the same thing. So as you can see, you have both all the information now to build and the example, Java code example, to build the application. Now we will take a look to the Java code to manage all the application. So this is based on Eclipse, probably lots of you know very well. So you can see here the consumer part, how to read the Kafka information post about the fly, and then you can see all the parts to get the taxi location and to send an email for them. So this is a part regarding Kafka. So you can read a record in Kafka. So this is the consumer part, consumer record. And then you can take the flight numbers, the terminals, the number of passengers. And if, as you can see, if the number of passengers is higher than 50, then you can get the taxi and then send the message to the taxi. So this is our scenario when the number is higher to 50. So very easy to do also, because in the portal, you have all the Java code already written, and you can find it in many languages, of course, not only. So this is the part to get the taxi location. So this is an HTTP API call, traditional, so to see to get the taxi location, and then also a very classic send to send alert, very classical HTTP call to send information to the taxi. No, we can now run the code. I cross the finger, but I think it will work, of course. So now I will stop it just to see the information. Okay. As you can see, you have the flight number, number of passengers. You have the taxi, what are currently in the area. And then I can send now a message to taxi with the flight number to say the flight has landed. This is the number of the flight. And this is the number of passengers, terminal 4. So the taxi has all the information now to get passengers. So this is the end of the demonstration. So if I summarize what we see, we see a portal to document all the synchronous and both the synchronous and asynchronous API in a single Drupal portal. It's very interesting because this is a socialized part of the API. So as mentioned, Arno, and you will see the documentation of sync and async API, the documentation of schema registry. The example of code provided is very useful to build your application in different language. So this is a very huge investment from IBM, of course. This is the interesting part, and we will see the evolution now to this type of API. As Arno, we have a lot of customer now who is building a lot of scenario in the banking area, in the transport area, in all the area I see, insurance, a technical way, and on all this area, we see Kafka project. And of course, to build it and to expose this API, you need asynchronous API, of course, to do that. So this close my demonstration. I hope with Arno, we will give you an idea of what is, I think, API regarding REST API and how to manage both in a portal, in a scenario, how to socialize and export and document all and also manage all the lifecycle of this API, sync or async API, with the different release, etc. Donc, this is something new regarding, I think, this is my seventh participation to API Days, and the first day, the first year with Arno, we can introduce this this async API with a product with released is available for our customer. So I know, Arno, if you want to add something. We can't hear you, sorry.
Thank you. I think now it's open for questions, if we have questions on this, if you want to.
You can use the chat to get to post your message. So we can do post and get. So you make the post and with Arno, you make the get.
We can take your question asynchronously if you want. More question.
So be free to post it. And I will just share the screen to put on the screen our coordinate. So if you have some question after this meeting. Don't hesitate to contact Arno or I. We are we will have very happy to discuss with you. You can also set up some one-to-one during the API Day, event during these 3 days. We're just starting. So be free to set up one-to-one with Arno or I if you want to go to ask your question more freely or more confidentially or something like that. So you can do that. I will continue to share our coordinate. So if we have no more question, so we are waiting few minutes more. Again, don't be free to contact Arno and I. We will be happy to continue this discussion with you.
And thank you for listening. I hope you enjoyed it as we do with asynchronous API.
Yes, it's always a pleasure for us to participate to this API Days. It's very enthusiastic for everybody. Okay, I'm not sure there's some questions, so thank you very much for everybody. And I think we will close the session.
Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
So just one thing, maybe you are presenting another topic, Michel, tomorrow.
Yeah, and the case for you also.
Yeah, yes.
We have two more topics, yes, in the API Days. Please, Arno, introduce your session.
Yeah, I'm going to present AI-driven testing. So it's a pretty emerging topic regarding the use of AI technology to generate test automatic testing for synchronous API or any API in the future. So it's a pretty exciting topic to see all the challenges and what we do today.
Okay. I will have the pleasure to present a topic again on how to build complex API. So we have to orchestrate and coordinate complex API. You have to build it with messaging, with Kafka, with transactional messaging, also with an orchestrator, with a bus, an orchestrator to manage it for complex API. And we will have a discussion about how to manage complex API with a bus, on the Swagger, with the assembly. There is a different way to do that. So it's more a discussion with you to discuss how to do that.
Cool. Okay. So thank you very much, everybody.
Yeah, and Cathy, thanks to mention the next session from IBM beginning soon, about API and data privacy session with Alan Glickels. Thank you, Cathy. Yeah.
Thank you, Alan.